Hey, my name is Bailey Spindle. I live in Bethany, Oklahoma, and I felt a call to ministry since eighth grade, and I believe that this is part of that calling, so I hope you enjoy my message. Hear the word of the Lord from Luke 15, 17 through 20. One day, Jesus was teaching, and Pharisees and teachers of the law were sitting there. They had come from every village of Galilee and from Judea and Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal the sick. Some men came carrying a paralyzed man on a mat and tried to take him into the house to lay him before Jesus. When they could not find a way to do this because of the crowd, they went up on the roof and lowered him on his mat through the tiles into the middle of the crowd, right in front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "Friend, your sins are forgiven." So my dad is a handyman, and he likes to do things around the house. One time a few years ago, he was fixing this light in my parents' bedroom, and he was fixing and everything, so he was up in the attic to do it, and he had just finished everything, so he was walking back through, and he was walking on the beam so he wouldn't step on the actual ceiling, and so he was walking through, and I guess, in his words, the contractor missed a beam in the layout of the house. And so he's walking and and then he steps on what he thinks is the beam, but it's not. And so he trips through the ceiling, and he sticks his foot up really quickly on the other beam, and he's holding the other beam, so he's just hanging through the ceiling, freaking out. And Brooklyn is freaking out in the other room, my sister, and my mom is freaking out, and they can't find it because the doors to all of our rooms are closed. And so it's just this whole big chaotic thing, and he just decides to fall. And so he lands on a bed, luckily, but unlucky for me, it was my bed. So he's, the whole ceiling is on my floor, and it's all messed up, and my room is all messed up, and he tried to patch it up, but don't tell him this, he did a really bad job. And so there's just you look up on my ceiling now, and there's just this big square of, that's unlike the rest of my ceiling. But the point behind that story is, it's just funny, falling through a roof, but the real point of this scripture is the friends who bring this man to Jesus. This man couldn't do it by himself. He was unable to. And these men decided that they loved Jesus enough, and they believed in Jesus enough, and they cared about this man enough who couldn't do it by himself, to pick him up and take him to Jesus. And they didn't just stop there. When the crowd was too big for them to get through, when there seemed to be so many obstacles to get to Jesus, they decided to think different and to take a new route. So they take him up to the roof and they lower him through this ceiling. And I think that's just so powerful. And these friends and these men are a great example to us of who we should be as friends and as Christ followers. And so as we look around at our lives and at the people around us, I think it's really important that we recognize the people who can't get there by themselves, and to be people that pick up their mat for them and take them to Jesus.
That's good.